First on the list is Filecoin. Filecoin is a decentralized storage network that was created in 2014 by Protocol Labs. Filecoin is by far the largest on this list with a market cap of $7.5 billion, which is exactly why I'm starting out with this one. As of now, Filecoin is kind of the Bitcoin of storage cryptos. It's the biggest dog, it's the household name. On top of Filecoin, Protocol Labs has seven other projects that all have the same mission as Filecoin, building a foundation for Web 3.0. So Filecoin is a decentralized storage network. This is where a network of nodes, which is simply computers running blockchain software, provides storage space in order to decentralize and secure users' files. So how does it work? Well, there are different types of decentralized storage networks. Filecoin uses a system called IPFS that was developed by their parent company, Protocol Labs. And if you want to know what IPFS stands for, it stands for Interplanetary File System. And if you heard that and you thought to yourself, interplanetary? Yes. Interplanetary. We're living in the future. An IPFS file storage system, due to it being permanent and distributed, could hypothetically be shared across planets. No one tell Elon Musk. So not to be geeky here, but this is because it wouldn't ever have to reference a central server. Well, our current protocol, HTTP, does. So the Filecoin blockchain is actually just a layer built on the IPFS system. It doesn't do any file storing itself. It's just a ledger for transactions of the FIL coin, which is used as a store of value so users can pay fees that create incentives for node operators. So here's how the system works. If you were looking to store files on this network, you would upload your files. Those files would then be broken off into mini pieces and stored with nodes providing their storage space. When you want to retrieve these files, the network determines the closest node to retrieve that data for you. Now, if you are a node operator looking to make some sweet cash from providing storage space, you would stake your FIL coin for the opportunity to provide storage. This would allow you to dedicate a certain amount of storage. The network then fills that storage with pieces of user data, and fees are paid by the users using that storage space that would then go straight into your pocket. And if a node ever decides to delete or tamper with a user's data, the data is compared to other holders of that data. Remember, it's all decentralized. And if it doesn't match up, the bad actors' staked FIL coins are then slashed. I could have used this last week. There was a power surge here in Puerto Rico, and it completely fried my computer. I lost 500 gigabytes of data, including 2 finished videos. Thanks for tuning in. And if you enjoyed this content, make sure you subscribe to the main channel as well, right here.